description of this technique, Abyaas vairagya, can be found in the Yoga Sutra of Patanjali, Chapter 1, Sutra 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16, as well as for those who really want to see further, Chapter 3. Chapter 3 is enumerating all the mysterious siddhis that I talked of, that a yogi can have. So Chapter 3 is about those vibhuti path, as it is called. So what are the siddhis that one can have? In that also there is a mention of Abhyas vairagya in one of the sutra, that is the 10th sutra. Now, the fact that a writing of that kind, sutra, you understand? Sutra means making a sentence absolutely brief, so short, so small, that there is not even a single dot, the in it, or a matra, or a half a letter that is possible to leave behind. If it is possible to drop half a letter from a sentence, it would be done. It is that kind of condensed writing. And in that kind of writing, if Patanjali is giving 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 5 sutras, in addition, one more, 6 sutras, you can understand the importance of this method, this technique, and this master. So that itself is telling us how important is Abhyas and vairagya. Before I go into the technicalities, it is important to first bring to surface what in our mind is regarding these two words. Because these are common words we use in Hindi also. I think in Gujarati, Marathi also similar words are used. So what do we mean by these words in our day-to-day language when we use them? Anyone? Anything? Abhyas? Study. Very good. Anything else does it mean?
Swadhyay.
Kind of swadhyay. Yes. What else does it mean?
Putting some under practice as a some ritual kind of thing every day or
something. It has to be, you mean to say repeated. When you say ritual, you really mean that it is repeated. Very good idea. Anything else that comes to your mind when you say Abhyas?
Study and observance in same terms.
Exactly. Means there is, it is not just repeated, it's repeated probably in the same sequence.
Observed and studied simultaneously.
Simultaneously. It's not therefore a simple one-step kind of thing, right? You are able to see the, it's a gamut kind of a thing, yes? It is a whole lot of things. It's not something, one, just, okay, fine, you have to put water for the sun. So you just go and do that. It is an entire series of things that has to be done in order to offer water to the sun. Is that right? Okay. You are getting to the point very rightly, as what Patanjali also
mentioned. Like walk, talk, observe and keep on.
It's kind
of a constant system.
So can you recall yourself doing this kind of? No. Okay. Let me categorically say no. Though lot of people do misinterpret Abhyas as ritual. Yes.
Because by normal terms, Abhyas means only study. Normal terms.
Just as sir just now mentioned, not just doing, observing while doing it and constantly progressing through that. In a ritual, you remain where you are.
Yeah.
It's mechanical.
Steadiness.
The very inherent characteristic of ritual is mechanical. You don't need to pay attention, you don't need to feel it, you don't need to watch how it is progressing, you don't need to change it. And it does not bring about much change in you. I will not totally discount it, and therefore I use the word much. Because it has its own value, and there are a lot of people who need it very badly. So it has its own place, I will not totally kind of run it down, but it has its own value. And Abhyas is not talking about ritual. It's much more than that, very true. I would like you, at this point, to, if you can, recall and share with us sometime when you have done anything one, or maybe if you're doing now, something in this context of Abhyas. Is there anything that you are doing which you can call as Abhyas? Or you've done sometime in the past which you can call as Abhyas? In whatever meaning. The self who is undergoing all the changes, whether it is in a routine, whether it is perfecting a task, whether it is understanding the whole thing or studying the whole thing, you know, or whether it is commitment, the changes that are taking place outside are not relevant, not important, are secondary when it comes to learning, knowing and practicing. If all these things are not for the experiencer, is not making a difference, is not making you more aware of your own self, then it is not
good.
In all these things that we are doing, the key person is self. It has to be of you. We then get in touch with ourselves first before we go ahead and understand what Patanjali is trying to say. Because we won't understand his words till we are with self. Okay? So a small technique to get in touch with ourselves. We'll do what is called, technically called as Sukhasana, which has to be otherwise done on the floor, but we can slightly modify it and do it sitting on the chair. Okay? Yes, sir, you can leave your book here. Yeah, feet firmly on the ground with your knees more or less at 90 degree angle. Your toes pointing in front. Place your feet in such a manner that your toes are pointing in front. Very good. Hands on your knees. Back straight. Now, the back of this chair is slightly at an angle. So if you are totally leaning on it, you will not be sitting straight. The lower portion of your back should touch the back of the chair. And then the upper portion slightly move it away and you'll find you're sitting straight. Pull up your back. Pull up your back as if there's a golden thread by which your head is being pulled up. Pull up. Yes, excellent. Now, see that your elbows are loose, not tightened. Yes. Shoulders square, not pulled back, not drooped down. Eyes fixed in front at one point. Fix your gaze. While you fix your gaze, what will happen is the eyeball, which otherwise will keep moving when you will close your eyes, will not do that. To help it further, stick your tongue to the palate also. There's a soft portion or bump in your mouth. Stick your tongue. Excellent. When your eyes are fixed, when your gaze is fixed, you're not looking here and there, your eyeballs are not moving, that is when you will slowly close your eyes. Count your breath. Count 1 as you breathe in, 2 as you breathe out, 3 as you breathe in, 4 as you breathe out, 5 as you breathe in, 6 as you breathe out, 7 as you breathe in, 8 as you breathe out, 9 as you breathe in, 10 as you breathe out. Now, keeping your eyes closed, mentally just check. See if your feet are in the same position as you had kept them earlier. If not, set them right. Check that your knees are comfortably placed. Your hands are nicely placed on your knees without any problem. No pressing of your wrist. Check that your elbows are loose, back is straight, shoulders are square, head, neck and back are in one straight line. Eyeballs are not moving inside the eyelids. Tongue is stuck to the palate. Start counting your breath in the same manner.